What's up, guys? It's Super. I'm really mad right now. The Boss Befriend event is over. Blah, blah, blah. Stuff. Wibble Wobble Me event. I had. You can now make yokai, and there's a trading event at Walmart. You can now make your own Wibble Wobble with different hairstyles. The Infinite Inferno's here in Mimikine. That's all you gotta know. Because I don't wanna explain it all over again. Because I just made this 38-minute long video. Stupid 38-long video of me doing this entire first circle of the Infinite Inferno. And then, when I went to save it, it said, save successfully. So obviously, I know that it's for it to not take up all my memory on AirShow, and on the camera photos, I had to delete it from AirShow. But you know what happened? It said, save successfully. So I was like, oh, it must have already saved to my camera roll. So I go, I delete it, I go to my camera roll, it's not there. It never appeared there. And now, because of the stupid text, I gotta do the entire Infinite Inferno all over again. And I actually already did it, so I'm not really doing it all over again. I'm just doing it again. Now that that's all out of me, it's time to do 9-1 through 9-13. That's like 13 stages I think we gotta do here, so let's do it all over again. And that first video was really good. It was really good. We had lots of fun. I didn't know what to expect. And now I know. I know that things are gonna be really, really hard. And I didn't actually lose one time, though. Just gonna say that. And later on, coming up soon, we're gonna encounter a very hard stage. And it's gonna be really hard. And the bad thing about this is that it's 8 o'clock now. It's not early in the morning anymore. Which means that my grandpa's gonna come walking out of the room, and he's gonna start talking during the video, and for once, I actually had a video without interruptions. And now I'm gonna have one with interruptions. Why does this happen to me? Why is things always happens to me? This is so sad. I'm really sad. My gosh, how are we not taking this guy out? Jeez, it took 3 souls to move. I never actually noticed. Then, so the first 2 stages are pretty easy, but once we get to that Nomi stage, things are gonna get a bit hard. But just to get it out of the way, we're gonna show off the Wibble Wobble Me mode. Now, last time I made a really funny picture, as you can see right here, it's my tough face. It was really funny though, because it looks like a kissy face. It looks so stupid. So now I'm just gonna make another one. So let's see. Let's do one with Kumasan. Now, usually I wouldn't show my face in a video, but I'm just gonna put the thing right over my eyebrows. Really stretches out. I'm trying to get it straight. Okay. Sure, why not? Boom. Man, that's not as funny as the other one, but you know, it's still okay. I'm gonna have to take the spirit from my inbox, too, because I used almost all my spirit just to get through the first part of this Infinite Inferno. Alright, then. So next time it says save successfully, I'm gonna go ahead and wait until it actually goes in there. I'm not gonna read the text. It said save successfully. I gotta stop talking about this, because then the video is just gonna be ranting about how stupid that thing was. But yeah, so anyway, this is actually, I thought this was a throwback, because there was a stage in the Sewer A, which was, it was a stage in Sewer A with Dumb Cap and Wazap, but instead of Wool Kappa being in the middle, it was, Palisaw. And I thought this was a throwback, but it's probably not. I was just guessing. Of course, I can't get Snottle, so it's meant like always. Oh, we did it. Okay, I wanted to press that, thing, but... we got a dumb cap. Yay.
I'll be friends.
Derp. It's gonna happen any minute now. Usually he wakes up around 9. I'm not sure, but I gotta get this done before 8:30. Because then I have to go into the room, sit at the computer desk, and do school. And it's gonna be really annoying because it's school. And school is just bleh. No! What the heck? What the heck is that? But not the blade. And then again, I don't have Snartle's ultimate. Look at this. There are barely any Snartles on screen right now. Oh my goodness, we got some tender beef skewers. Wow. You know, in the thing that they explained, Infinite Inferno, they didn't actually describe what special rewards you get for beating these bosses. It never said. It just said you could get some special rewards, even though we knew beating it on your first try gets you a soul secret. So, I mean, how does that work? You know, I really wish that they actually, like, sold the S parts, like, in the thing that was right here. Like, why didn't they do that? Because it would have made things a little easier, besides getting it from the Crane Kayak. You know, you would actually have to grind on the boss stages in order to get the points you need. You would need, like, 1,000 points for SV Snaggerjack points, or 1,000 for, 1,000 for Slimamander, 1,200 for, maybe, SV Snaggerjack, 1,250, and then 1,500 for, Sprink S parts. I mean, that would have been pretty good. I mean, would that have worked? Possibly. It probably would have worked. But instead, they just sold some stuff. Like, 1-star coins, some occasional coins, some 5-star coin, oh, not occasional coins, the kind of coin that I forgot the name of. I actually have to save one of my Soultimate moves here, because I have to finish with the Soultimate move on this stage, I believe, so. We're just going to go like this. Oh no. He's alive again. Or not stunned. What is Spimp based off of? I mean, he looks like, he's like this weird tongue shell thing. I don't know. I don't know what it is. Hey, we come here. Kato. Now, I think the spemp stage, or the Nomi stage, it asked me to use Kaden. And I was like, no, I'm not going to use Kaden, because I don't want to use someone as weak as Kaden. Like, no offense to Kaden, but I think they just kind of put using all these weaker yokai as, like, a troll thing, like, to make people, completionists specifically, waste all their spirit and have to probably, like, use Y money in order to, you know, get more if they weren't patient. Actually, no, that wouldn't make any sense. They probably just did that as a troll move just to make people waste their spirit. You know, it's a joke of sorts. Yeah, that's not like something I would do. No, I'm just kidding. If we get that second Sogan yarn, I'm gonna be very happy. Alright. Oh, right in the middle. Wow. Right in the middle of the wibwobbing screen. The bonus ball. Oh, never mind. Looks like I won't be getting that second Oh, actually, I will. Okay. Boo! Like, Ruff Ruff's just sitting there after I stunned him. He's like, pondering, like. And then all of a sudden. And then he's dead. Or, he's not dead, because he's a yokai. But, another yokai that I don't know what it's based off of. And you know, Negatibuzz is based off of a mosquito. But, what is Ruff Ruff based off of? I mean, Tublappa, I don't know either. A lot of these yokai are really weird. They're probably based off of maybe some Japanese mythology or something, because Tublappa is one of the classic yokai, I think. Boyclops in Yokai World actually says, they call us the legendary yokai. Even though that's clearly a typo, it's the classic yokai, not the legendary yokai. And they've kind of put legendary because they didn't know what else to call it, but just call them classic yokai. I mean, it's no Japanese, it's not even a Japanese translation. I mean, whatever they were saying in the Japanese version translates to classic, so just use classic. Bada bing, bada boom. You got yourself a game, or you got yourself some different yokai that are stronger than the others. Now, for some reason, I can't actually take these guys out in one hit. It's kind of annoying, because usually after one fever in any stage that I do, they'll all die after one fever. But in this game, nope, you don't get that. Not in this game, in this area, you know, it doesn't work that like that. You gotta actually try more. I mean, I'm getting destroyed right now. I'm gonna die soon. I should probably use Bonito Blade and finish clear favor. All right, lion. No, I forgot. I gotta take the stuff's out of this. Oh, 500 Y money, that's good. I tried to actually get Mimic and A on my previous attempt to record this video. I tried to get Mimic and A out of the Krankikai, and I got an Alu. Stupid Alu. Model F Jibanyan. Oh, that's cool. I can't wait for them to actually put in Robanyan Form F. I actually really want that. Alright, we got 8 spirit. I think that should be enough, right? That should be enough, right? To get to the end of this area, I think. Rockabilly. Now, when I first did this, I got like 3 items. One from the first time doing the stage bonus, and I think you get amazing milk or a crab omelet, which is a Chinese food, of course. And I also got one of the rockabillies, the one on the left over here that I pinpointed, but now it's gonna get the other one instead. He dropped a double burger, and then when I defeated Lion, I got a chocolate milk. And who knows why Lion has chocolate milk on him? Because, I mean, he doesn't drink chocolate milk. He eats Chinese food. I mean, you always gotta have a drink. But, I mean, still, chocolate milk. Oh my gosh, and then I dropped this Wibble. Wow. You know, things happen when I talk about them. I just have a feeling that that's what it is. Oh! And he's destroyed. Oh, nothing. Okay, he didn't drop the chocolate milk. We got a rockabilly. Wow. Come on, let's be friends. I'll do a belly dance for you every day. No, I do not want that. I do not want that. No, I don't want your face flop either. Weird bird thing. So 9, 8, and 9, and then I would do 10, 11, 12, oh yeah, yeah, I took just the right amount of spear. I'll have like 2 left over to do maybe some stages just in case I need wine. But now it's time to step up, and that means it's another rematch against the Jancing Trio. I don't even know what purpose these guys serve. We just keep fighting them in certain areas, and it's kind of annoying. I mean, we fought them at the beginning of the game, then we found them in, then we went over to downtown Springdale, and they were there too, and then we had another rematch against them in the Excellent Tower, and now they're like, you know what? He's coming to the Infinite Inferno, so this is our final challenge. We're gonna fight Super Silver again. I was actually trying to, like, when I was trying to make my own, like, profile description thing on my Miiverse, I tried to put, hey, I have a YouTube channel, but no, apparently I have an administrator. Stupid administrator. That's like, oh, you broke the rules. And I'm just like, okay, yeah, then. But then he said I broke the rules last time by putting another way to become friends with someone. When really, that's one of the only ways you can become friends with someone if they permit not to take more friend requests, because it was actually a friend that I know, and he permitted not to take any more friend requests, so he had to put in my ID, and so I was like, you need to do, I put in the chat that you need to do this, because it says that you have to, in order to become friends, and then a few moments later, like a day later, I go back to that chat, and I see that it was deleted by the admin, not the person who made the, oh no, it was actually, when I went back into my notifications, I saw a message from Miiverse administrators, and they were like, you broke the rules by putting another way to make friends, and I'm just like, what? Do they not know? Do the people that are in charge of this Miiverse stuff not know that if a person is permitted not to have a friend request anymore, to receive friend requests, that they actually have to put in the code, their ID? I mean, that's just the way to do it. I was asking him, can you please do this, because now you gotta put in my ID, but no, it didn't work. And then I actually went into other ones where they actually said put in my ID, and then it says that you need to put in my ID, and they didn't have that problem. They weren't deleted by their administrator. I don't even know what's going on. I don't know. I'm not in a good mood. Maybe I'm hungry. Sometimes when I'm hungry, I'm in a bad mood. Oh, I got Tender Reef Skewers again. Oh my gosh. Too bad Eterna doesn't do damage and heal. It has 21 health, so I'm gonna go like Kapow. I can't wait for them to put more localized yokai, like Broken Brella and Papa Windbag's already in the game, but he kind of stinks. Then there's a, you know, they actually made a lot of the new yokai, like, not very good. Because, I mean, at the beginning of the game, you get Lion, you get Toblappa, you get Nomi, but then you kind of just kick them to the side. You kick Toblappa and Nomi to the side, and you bring it, you keep using Lion because you get the Lion Heart, which is a really strong yokai for like, a good portion of the entire game. But no, when you start getting towards the end of the game, you know, he's not really that good anymore. But I forgot to view these guys' stats. I was so surprised when I saw this 507 attack power. I'm gonna give him a beef tongue just because he's so strong, but 12,000 health as well. Now, he's literally stronger than Shadow Venom. I mean, if these two had a battle, this one would win. Seriously, wow, it's pretty crazy how much attack power he has, but he's really just a hee hee heel. Now, when I first saw this, I thought it was just going to be another rematch with all three of the snakes. But nope, it was this guy, hee hee heel, the lone sulf. Because that makes sense. And he just wanted to fight me all by himself without his two best buddies, Cronjur and Anaconda, helping him out. But he had been training more than those two, and now he was ready to fight me. I have a feeling when I go to the second circle, like it's gonna be like, hey, now you gotta fight Cronjur by himself, and he just 600 damage. Oh, we actually got him. See. We got him because he's so strong. Oh, these two are so close to living up. Let's be friends so I can look at it every day. Wait, what? That made no sense. Woo! Well, I feel like I saw a red whisper on my screen. Look at that fast. This area looks really cool. I like how they actually add the Infinite Inferno background in battle, and I really like the look of the Infinite Inferno in general. It's really awesome. But we're already almost done with this area. We got the E team, and by that, the rank E team, because all three of these guys have been training for so long, and now they're ready to fight me with all the power that they have. But they're still just, yeah, they're not really that good. I'm still going to beat them. I have a feeling that they want revenge, because anytime that I want to grind for Y money, sometimes I just do the entire game all over again. Like, I just kind of play through it all, a good few of the stages until I have 3,000 Y money, use that 3,000 Y money, then I keep going. Stuff like, kind of like that, but I would always obviously do Uptown Springdale first, which means I would just destroy Boohoo with one Wibble pop. Sometimes not even a big Wibble. She just dies. And then Pandle has more health, but I mean, he's still weak. And then Pickpocket, he probably wants revenge for me grinding on his stage, trying to get lots of pickpockets to get that general soul to drop for pain, which I never was actually able to get in this file. I think I might have gotten it to drop, but I wasn't able to get in the other one. I actually had to complete a mission, but these guys are holding on. These guys are holding on tight. Oh, I thought she was going to drop the Wibble, because when I actually first did this, Boohoo decided to be my friend, and she was like, you know what, I'm done being weak. This one's going to make me strong, and I'm probably not even going to use Boohoo ever. Oh man, we got pretty low there. They are pretty strong, but Boohoo did become my friend. Not this time, but last time. And we finally got to level 46 and 44, with Cruncha being 44 and Snortle being 46. I think we're doing really well. And now we only have the last two stages, obviously. we already knew that Idra was going to be the last thing. Oh, wait, what? Okay. Oh, wow. I was like, no, don't do this now to me. Wait, did the network error? Okay. I thought the network error might have made Airshot go out. I gotta make sure I save a Sultimate, because when I first tried to do this, I actually failed at finishing with the Sultimate move, because I was being a little too reckless, and then that's what happened, really, so. One of my friends on Wii U, on Miiverse, actually plays Skylander Superchargers, so I'm wondering if maybe I could do one of my videos for Superchargers. I still haven't gotten back to Superchargers yet. I just really don't feel like doing a lot of Superchargers videos. For some reason, I don't know. I don't know why. It's just kind of a me thing. Because I haven't played the game in a long time, and I mean, I've beaten it like 4 times. This is going to be my 5th time beating the game. I mean, that's really good. Well, it just seems like I'm playing way too much, and it won't be worth it, because I'm just going to beat the game. There's no extra stuff, unlike Super Mario 3D World, which I still haven't done the Star World for. I actually still haven't done Star World. And I got to do Mushroom World. I might not even do it, because I can't beat Champions Road. I can't beat Champions Road. To this day, I still can't beat it. It's been 3 months. I've been, every now and then, probably once a month, I would try and beat it. I just can't beat it. The farthest I've gotten into is the part with all those dash pads. I would just get hit and fall off the edge sometimes, and because no checkpoints, you go all the way back to the beginning. But here we are, Idra. And he is much stronger. And I'm just going to say right now, Whisper says, I've seen this guy before. This is Idra. He looks just like Slamander. He has 3 big heads just like Slamander. Aim for the eye and its mouth. And aiming and attacking an eye with the mouth not with the mouth with that's not open will do no damage. I think that's what it is. And then it explains to you that. But unlike Slamander, this guy changes his mouth every 5 seconds. Yeah, that's right. Usually it's 10 seconds for Slamander, but there. Look at that. He already changed eyes, and it's really annoying because you gotta constantly be looking at the top screen because he will change his eye every 5 seconds, and it's really annoying because, I mean, come on. You wanna actually have some time. Well, look at that. He's gonna change eyes. No, I didn't want that. So, you just gotta be watching the top screen. And you will be fine. I'm just gonna 0-0-0. This is actually a pretty tough fight, but it's beatable. It's not impossible. It's not impossible to beat. I feel like his head's going back because he's actually about to open that specific eye, so. And this is going to only do like 2,000 damage right here because, or 3,000 because all the other eyes took their damage, so. And what's really good is if you have Sandy, it helps even more because you could just attack that specific guy for a long time, a longer amount of time. Okay, I think I almost got my Shogunyan Sultimate move. Oh. Well, I did not mean to press that, but that was actually a pretty good accidental move on my part. So, I just noticed I haven't been attacking the correct eye. Oh my gosh, things are getting down to the wire. Oh my gosh. Whoa, his tongue is right out at me, about to hit me in the face. Oh no. I don't actually know which eye is open. I'm just gonna hope that the one that I'm aiming at is actually open and it'll do more damage to that one. We did it! Oh, yes! I beat it twice. And on my first try. I'm not actually sure what Slamander can actually drop. I guess I would have to grind on him, but I don't want to. But if you beat him on your first try, you get yourself an awesome, awesome, awesome soul secret that I feel like I should be nice and just use it on Slamander S. But I mean, I'm not going to be using Slamander S as much as Spoink S. Because Spoink S is really strong. Just telling you guys right now, I'm probably going to be using more of my soul secrets on Spoink S. I might use one on Slamander S eventually, but we're just going to use this on Spoink S until he gets really high in the levels. But that's going to be it. That is going to be it for this episode. I mean, we could do a little money grinding. I mean, I got some Y monies. We could make this video a little bit longer by just going over to SV Snaggerjag. By warping there. Should probably warp there. Mirapo warp. Mirapo or Mirapo? I don't know. But let's just do some SV Snaggerjag money grinding. We're going to use 3,000 Y money on the Cranky Kai just to end this off. You know, I hope I get Mimikin A, but I probably won't. I don't even know what Mimikin A does. Is it like a stronger guard, or does he actually attack? Because it says that he mimics a huge giant in order to make Wibwobs become larger, but then it doesn't actually do that. It's just a defense. Oh, I forgot about this guy's gimmick again. Why do I keep forgetting? Oh, I probably shouldn't be doing that because I don't want to kill him, I just want to. Alright, the guillotine. This attack. The guillotine is for naughty brats. And I don't know what to put Bonino Blade in. I don't know. Come on, get that 8,000. Oh, we got the 8,000, yes. And you can no longer actually befriend this guy. As soon as I thought I was actually going to befriend him. But no, the befriend a boss event is over. So you cannot befriend bosses anymore. That's very lucky that I got Salmon Row to drop from him. Right as I was talking about that. Alright, come on. I'm actually going to do a Slamander as the last thing that we do. Maybe we'll get the 3,000 by just fighting Slamander. Who knows? Who can say for certain? Alright. Oh my gosh, so many Sandies right now. Wow. I'm gonna actually kind of link all these. Oh, but I also gotta use all my Sultimates, so we should probably hurry up with that. And finally. Oh, I got it. Yes. Much better. How much money does that give me? 169. So just doing Slamander, I think will give us the amount of Y money we need. So we might as well use my Mimikin over here. As much as I don't want to at all. There's my Mimikin. Mimic my Komasan face. Let's just call it that. Let's just call that my Komasan face, my Badignon face, which kind of looks like a kissy face when it's supposed to be a tough face, but I blinked, And then I don't even know what the Jibaya one is. This is just a creepy smile. A creepo smile. And then the Shogunyan one, it was just a smile. Mimic. Okay, we're just gonna wait for him to attack. Okay, we're gonna go mimic. 2, 1. Take 30 damage. We gotta set this up here, so. Did I set it up correct? Oh no, looks like I didn't. Oh, never mind, I got it. Yeah, I can get the 7,000. Can I get the 7,000? We got the 7,000. Yay. Wow, that did not do much at all, did it? Oh. We should end with the counterpart before doing the Kragekai. Come on, game. I should try and get my soul ultimates first, but I don't really need a healing soul ultimate, so I'm just gonna spam until I got it. Come on. There we go. Okay, we got one. That's one. Mimic. Mimic for luck. And finally, Bonito Blade, and we will have 3,000 wild money that we're gonna use on the Cranky King. Slime was actually the hardest for me to befriend. I never had I didn't actually have that much trouble with SV Snagajack. I didn't have very much trouble with Sproink. I actually got him on like my fifth try, or seventh, and SV Snagajack was shorter. But here we go. We actually had 3,075 Y money when I tried this the first time. So let's go. Here's to Mimic and A, which I probably won't get. Oh man, I thought that was it right there. It was just Psynake. But that is going to be it for this episode. I should probably make one more. See, I've done. Wait, which one did I not do? I did four of the cats. So I guess I'm gonna do Bizarria. Okay, let's see. I got, like, emo hair. And I was blinking. I was looking down. No. I got a smile at the screen. There we go. Even though I look so stupid. What the heck? Hooray. Now we got Bizarria. that is going to be it now. That's going to be it. Thank you guys so much for watching. And I'll see you guys next time when we do... the second circle of the Infinite Inferno, where we will probably fight Hoggles. We'll see you guys then. Oh, and also, when you first come in, Whisper says, oh, this is the Infinite Inferno, where lots of strong yokai gather. If you get all the way to the end and beat the boss on your first try, you get a soul secrets. And then when you come in here, he says, oh, this looks like even stronger yokai are here. But I have a feeling the boss will have a bulbous belly button. Anyway, I'll see you guys next time.